Many devotees wanted to see Gurudev and wanted to invite him to their homes so he would bless their home and they would have the blessing of being able to feed him. So this is a little story about Prasad. So one such person was well noted for being a fantastic Indian cook. And she lived south of San Francisco. And I had the opportunity to drive Gurudev to a special luncheon that she had prepared for him. So we arrived, and it was not only she and her husband there, but all her friends were there, all these women who had also cooked and were there to serve. And I think there's something in the Indian tradition, they feel the more food you eat, the more blessing for them. They graciously invited me to join them for the meal. And then about 10 people were lined up to serve the food. So they went to Gurudev, and maybe there were a couple of other people seated at the table, and then to me, and served everyone all those items. And I looked at the food and I thought, this is more food than I can eat in a week. But I was brave. I knew it was going to be delicious. And I dived in. I thought, okay, I did my duty as a guest. I ate everything that was on my plate. Then they came around with seconds. And of course, Gurudev was accepting, you know, these 10 dishes are coming around, but I was already up to here. So as sweetly and graciously as I could, I said, no, thank you. And as they kept coming around with more things, I realized I couldn't keep saying, no, thank you. I had to accept something. I was, in a way, insulting the host. So I just said in my mind, I don't care what it is. Whatever the next item is, I'll say, okay, thank you, just a little, please. So the next item was rice. And I said, yes, please, thank you. And then all of a sudden, they were coming up with all the other dishes. And I said, no, the rice is okay. He said, you can't just eat rice. No one eats just rice. And before my eyes, I saw a mountain of food appear on my plate again. And I was sitting opposite Sri Gurudev. And I looked at him with focused attention. I just stared at him. And in my mind, I said, I will die if I eat all this food. It is impossible for my system to receive any of this food now. And I said, you're going to have to take care of it. You're going to have to take care of it. And I kept my eyes fixed on him. I couldn't even taste what I was eating. I was just doing my duty and politely putting it into my mouth, focused on him the whole time. After the meal, it felt like I hadn't even eaten. There was no digestive process. It just transmuted into a blessing in my system. It like sublimated. In chemistry, you have the term sublimate, when something solid can go to an invisible vapor state. It doesn't even have to go through a liquid transition. So that's what the food did. It went from solid to ethereal. And I experienced that one time before.